Welcome back and good morning, everybody. So let's continue where we left off last episode. I've put on the NAI tooltips for the items now, so when I'm mousing over things, I've tidied up the basement a little bit, and I've also been off mining, and I found a lava cave not too far from here. I also found these things. Now, I'm not sure if the light level here is incorrect for them. People where I've been reading up about it seem to suggest that you need a dark room, but they seem to be growing okay, and no monsters should spawn in here either. So these bushes, find them on the ground, you plant them in that size, and then when they grow, you can get back aluminium off that one or copper off these two, and they'll smelt just like any other ore. So a handy little thing. Now I have my put some lava in my smeltery now, so it's time to start smelting. I've also put another pattern chest just beside here for us. Okay, so first things we want to do is take some aluminium. We're going to take three and three and two bits of copper. Just going to use up the gravel first of all, and then place all that in. This will take up to nine. It's pretty cool that you can see the blocks placed in here. So the aluminium and the brass, we're making an alloy. Not sure which one of these books tells us about alloys in here. Yeah, okay, so we're creating aluminium brass, which we're using for blank casting. Okay, you can see that's melted down. So molten aluminium, and these two are just taking a little bit longer to complete. Okay, there we go, and then it's eight ingots of molten aluminium brass. Now, what we want to do with that is make some casts of items that we're going to then want to pour molten metal into. I'm just creating a bit of space here. So I've these eight items to start with that I want to be able to create casts for. Including one iron ingot. Now that's going to allow us to pour ingots. Okay, so I'm just going to go through and pour casts for all of these items. Just place them in. Oh, these are just the stone heads that I've made upstairs in the way that you saw last episode. Okay, so it took one ingot per cast, and all eight of the casts that I was looking for are done now, and that's them here. I'm just going to store them temporarily over here because I was interested in doing one other thing, which is expanding my smeltery. Well, I'm interested in doing lots of things, but we'll get on with expanding the smeltery first. So, got a lot more bricks smelted up. Okay, so I'm going to want another faucet. Another smeltery drain, and then another item that we can pour molten ore into, and that is the casting basin. Now, the casting basin allows us to create, rather than just an ingot at a time, nine blocks of nine ore. So let's place that down there. that here, this here. Okay, now as you increase the height of this, more ore can be smelted at the same time. Oh, and if you're in here, you'll take damage. Now I want to move all of these at one. Just to leave this at a more manageable height. So just take one of our blocks there. This. So it's good that you can get all the components back when you do something like that. Just got a junk chest over here. Okay, so that's almost ready to go. Okay, so that now allows more ores to be smelted at the same time. Still not scrollable. Now, I think what do we need? Should we go another 8? How many is it? 6, 12. Yeah, may as well. So 3 more. You can just keep on adding blocks to the top of this, increase the capacity and the amount of ores you can smelt at the same time. So now it does appear to be scrollable. Right, let's grab my iron out and go. Okay, well that's how we're going to smelt down the iron. And then we have an option, do we create iron blocks out of it, or if we take our cast out of here, we can also create metal ingots that way as well. But first of all I'm keen to get some iron pickaxe and sword. So let's see, pickaxe, sword. I'm gonna keep the Now, what was it Stonebound gave us? So Stonebound will make tools work faster the lower they are on durability. So rather than create an iron tool binding for my pickaxe, what I'm going to do is just use stone, and that'll give me stone bound on that tool, I think. Anyway, we need 2 of these, and let's pour a block out. So there's our iron rod. Right, 2 iron rods, and a pickaxe head. There you go, and that's how we're getting blocks of iron. And we want a sword blade. So let's see, we've got the iron pickaxe head, iron sword blade. Now, using iron completely would allow us to add extra durability to the items, but let's just get this built. And there was some left over, so we'll use the stone guard and that. Okay, let's see about creating a pickaxe. So we've got iron, iron pickaxe head, and that. So it's 324 durability, and that's compared to 65 durability, so that's going to last us a lot longer. I was getting a bit tired about these stone pickaxes. Let's also create a sword. So it does 3 hearts of damage versus a stone, which does 2 hearts of damage. But it's also quite a lot more durable. Okay, so that's me ready to go off mining, maybe look for diamonds, redstone, that kind of stuff, now that I've upgraded my pickaxe from stone to iron. Okay, so, and I'm also going to continue smelting here. And it didn't show the creating the ingots, but that's the way to do it. So, iron bar. Okay, well, I'm going to continue smelting. I'm not going to have to go off mining and get diamonds and all the rest of the good stuff, and then we will be back and we'll see what we'll do after that. Okay, I'll see you in a little bit. Right, before I go off mining, I wanted to have a look at something else. It's a way to do a little bit of automation downstairs. So let's have a look. Oh, right. So we're going to need a hopper or two. Okay, so what I'm looking to do is at least automatically fill this chest with ores, or the bars, sorry, the blocks of the smelted ore. Let's see if that happens. Okay, so that's working good. And we could do the same thing over here for bars. Okay, next, if we just create a little stone button, can we do that without smooth stone? No. Interesting, that only pumps out one at a time. So we need a repeating redstone circuit. Well, you know, you can see how we're going to start automating this process. It seems to be clever enough to detect whether there's space underneath as well for it. But a quick timing circuit. Ooh, do we have anything like that now? I think red power might be out. And why is caps lock on? Yeah, we don't have a timer, so we might need to look at a way to do that. But basically, we just need a pulse, which is easy enough to set up. And of course, the other alternative. Is if we stick a lever here. Presumably that'll just keep on pouring. Or does it actually need a pulse? Oh, how unhelpful. So this could take a while until I'm properly set up in my base. And it might be a good opportunity to create a few more of these casting basins just to get more output. It all seems to be working well, and as you're extracting the ore, you can always add more ore in for smelting. Welcome back, guys. So I was just looking at a way to automate this. I've basically got a timer down here. So this redstone's torch inverts signal, passes signal through a 3 or on the setting of 3 repeater, then the redstone current passes back to this torch, which then comes up to here, and I've got the switch here that can switch the whole thing off. So there we go, it's timing away. This redstone signal will act like the button beside this, so it requests one pouring of one ingot into the basin here. So we can see that working. I don't want to put too much in just now. But I've got some problems with this. If I don't have enough ingots, or if I don't have 9 ingots worth of liquid in there, this will still click and ask to pour 1 ingot into the basin, say, or up to 9 ingots into the basin, which might mean that the basin is going to end up partially filled and no more ores to process. So I think the best thing for me is not to be casting the blocks, although we do have quite a few blocks now, and set up a few more of these ingots. So maybe 3 ingots along here. You can see now it's liquid's completed, so it's been requested because the circuit's on. And just having this switch up here rather than inside here allows the whole timing thing to go off, so reducing the lag if you want to. Yeah, see, the whole thing switches off. Okay, so I think I'm going to move this over to here just in case I do want to cast any blocks, and then I'm going to rearrange this so that I can get a timer going into 3 of these blocks. So we'll have to have a look at that. But I'll be back with you once I've poured out all this iron. Anyway, there's a good illustration of the problem I was talking about. If there isn't enough ore inside there, it'll just fill up this and leave it there. And you might want to start processing a different ore. I'm going to add in a couple of extra iron dust. I think that should allow it to complete. Yeah, okay, so I shall see you once I've ripped out some of this, and we'll have a look at what we're doing. Okay, we're back at the base, and I'm just looking at what we're going to do here. I've also increased the height. I thought, as I'm placing this up to the top now, and you'll see a reason for that in a second, but I thought I'd just get it to the maximum height we can in this room, which is there, because I still need one space on top. And that's to run some redstone wire up there. hoping this is going to work. I'm not sure, but we'll find out. So yeah, that's the floor of upstairs. So can't go any higher with this thing. So right at the maximum. That feels good. Okay, I've moved this across to here. If we want blocks, we can make them there. But the thing that we're going to automate is making the bars. Now I've got some. I'm going to connect these together into this chest, and I suspect I'm going to need a bronze bar. Oh, some bronze bars. One of those wrenches. One of these. Get the recipe here. So it's 3 to 1, same as the past. What happened to the tin? Smelted pretty fast. To the copper. Six ingots, hopefully that's enough. And do these need to be right underneath? Oh, I suspect so. Maybe. Or I could have really messed up. We'll find out, eh? Let's just place that here. Okay, so that's working fine. Alright, I'm gonna get these created and I'll be back with you. Okay guys, welcome back. I've had to move all those up, obviously, because we saw what happened when I hadn't before. So I thought we'd have a little work area here. I'm probably going to move some of the things down here, so we've got a workshop type thing going on. The reason we need to do this is we need a few more of these casts. Now that would normally be a problem if we wanted to get that to communicate with that, but really it's whatever this block state is we need to communicate. So that shouldn't be a problem. So redstone repeater just down here. Facing that way. And we're going to set it the delay to 3 again. next, we just want to feed back around into the block so we have a timer, switches on and off. And that worked. And does that switch it all off? No. Let's see, where is that positioned? Too high. It's a little bit too hidden, so let's move it. Right beside our furnace. And seeing that this could be a problem, I think what we're going to have to do is run redstone all the way around here. Okay, so it's off. Now it's on. Off again. Make a few of those. I think that would come in handy. Is Miss Craft on? Do we have Miss Craft installed? I think we do. They will come in handy. Right, so we're going to make a work table. And the reason for this is it remembers 8 recipes. So it's a crafting table that remembers recipes, and you can lock in the recipes. And the reason why I want that is because we're going to be repeating the same item a few times. I'm trying to decide how to lay this place out, because might as well have a workshop type area just here underneath there. It's got all the workings. So the thing I've decided to do about these is replace them with wooden transport pipes, and hopefully that'll suck the items out, but I'm gonna have to use redstone engines, so that's why I built this work table. The work table is going to allow me to get it to learn all the items for creating the redstone engine, and that way it's repeatable. So let's just stick that up there. That really doesn't fit. Just trying to. Right, we'll put it there for the time being. Okay, so first off, might as well learn how to create wood. And then it needs items down there. Okay, so now I've locked that in place. You can right click to lock it in place, so it'll remember that recipe. So now if we just click on that, it'll bring up the recipe again. Okay, next up, let's just do sticks. And then let's do, so this isn't auto crafting at all. It's just going to allow us to sort of build up what we need. So can we take any more of those? No. You can see it doesn't remember to be able to create these items, but we can just do that, that, that. So rather than having to put in the pattern each time. Okay, so how do the... we need 3 redstone engines. It's been a while since I've had to make one manually. Okay, wood across the top, glass, pistons are... Right, we need redstone. Some glass. I can't wait to get an automated system up and running. There's logistics pipes back in again. We were working on a couple of series ago. That was a bit of fun. And then we've also got the applied energetic stuff, which was a very neat solution for what we're doing. So not sure. Okay, so this will remember up to 8 items. Do need 3 of these, so let's just okay, there's our 3. And let's tell it about wooden transport pipes as well. I'm not sure what happens if that gets moved. Does it forget all its recipes? A small problem here with this layout. Okay, I think that should still work. Okay, so, right, getting there. Where do we want the engines and the pipes to go? Let's put the engines down the bottom. Have I built the wrong one? Iron pipes. still doesn't look right to me. Oh, I need to look at the wiring a little bit more compact down here. Just thinking about it. I think it can feed right in there. That's a lot more compact. Right, still can't see on those iron pipes, and there was definitely iron pipes placed down. Which way is active? So we'll have to come back to that. Seem a little bit weird on this item. It was always the solid end. This end it takes items from. Sends items to, but maybe it means that there's a lock on this side to stop things coming from that side. Same with this. So let's give that a go now. Okay, that's all working nicely. Well, I'm sorry about that, guys. We seem to have overrun slightly, but we'll be taking off from where we've left off there with the smeltery up and running now and looking to upgrade our tools. So I shall see you next time.